Seems like nowadays you can't go a day without hearing some type of advertisement about smart technologies such as smart meters, smart appliances, smart cards, smart energy, smart houses, and smart grid. Technology and the internet allowed us to advance and has enabled us to connect in ways never before imagined. But as time keeps slipping into the future, the more and more I see the internet being expanded and used as a systematic tool to spy on populations with the help of integrated smart technologies that will be essentially used to control everything within what is called the smart grid. The settings portrayed in the famous book written by George Orwell, 1984, are coming into our reality. Futuristic technological enslavement where Big Brother has full control of everything and knows all our actions at all times. A lot of people labeled as conspiracy theorists have warned the general public for years, and as we drift into the future, the more it seems that those labeled as conspiracy theorists are becoming correct in some of the things that they are trying to warn the public about. This film examines and explains the smart grid and how it will be used with integrated smart technologies to spy and control everything. This film will explain how it's all interconnected to an agenda put forth by the United Nations years ago known as Agenda 21. It all started back when they started implementing the smart meter. Not many people from Ontario even knew what the technology was going to be used for and thought no harm because in the minds of many, they trust their government's actions. The Ontario Energy Board is a corporation and is an agent of Her Majesty. Members of the board are appointed by the Lieutenant Governor General and Council. The Ontario Energy Board is one of the forces behind implementing the smart grid. On Wikipedia, it states that the Ontario Energy Board regulates natural gas and electricity utilities in the province of Ontario. This includes setting rates and licensing all participants in the electricity sector, including IESO, generators, transmitters, distributors, wholesalers, and electricity retailers, as well as natural gas marketers who sell to low-volume customers. It also states that the board provides codes of conduct for gas marketers and electricity retailers, and the board oversees the electricity market. So it all started out in 1998 when Parliament enacted Ontario Energy Board Act, Section 1. The Ontario Energy Board in relation to electricity is to facilitate the implementation of a smart grid in Ontario and to promote the use and generation of electricity from renewable energy. Well, what exactly is a smart grid? According to the Electricity Act, it means the advanced information exchange systems and equipment, when utilized together, improve the flexibility, security, reliability, efficiency, and safety of the integrated power systems and distribution systems. The smart grid will combine the use of non-renewable energies and renewable energies. With a combination of smart technologies that communicate with the smart grid, the smart grid will be able to store and collect data of whatever is desired. We will examine this later. The benefits of a smart grid is that it can distribute current of electricity quicker to spots that had something go wrong in the electrical power grid. Special metering allows consumers to see how much electricity they are using during what hour to make better decisions on electrical consumption management. Mostly it's more beneficial for hydro companies because the smart grid can detect where problems are within the grid. All of this proposed and passed in legislation, unseen by the public and unimplemented for years. But on January 26, 2005, the board submitted its implementation plan on smart meters to former Minister of Energy, Donna Cansfield. It wrote in the notice, quote, "The government of Ontario has established targets for installation of 800,000 smart electricity meters by December 31, 2007. And installation of smart meters for all Ontario consumers by December 31st, 2010. The beginning of the implementation of the smart grid was the implementation of the smart meter. According to Ontario Regulation 393/07, made under the Electricity Act, Independent Electricity System Operator, which is also known as IESO, is designated as the smart metering entity, which means they are the corporation responsible for collecting smart meter information and data for the smart meter data management system. IESO is licensed by the Ontario Energy Board. Ontario Regulation 442 is the force that strive to install smart meters.
This is our hydro provider, and this is really essentially where the smart grid started, was with the electrical system.
Now, remember when the smart meters first started coming out, they went around the homes, and I'm pretty sure almost everybody I spoke to said they didn't want it, and the hydro company agent actually informed them, saying that they will not be receiving any hydro if they do not convert their meter into a smart meter.
And they actually sold the smart meters as being a way to save money. You can control how much your bill will be, you can monitor it online, you can use hydro at the amount where it's at times of the day where it's cheaper.
The smart meter actually collects data of hydro usage in your home and sends that data back to the hydro company,
where the hydro company then in turn sends it to a government database, who then sends it back for the billing.
And also third parties, they can sell this information to third parties too.
Yep. And as it is right now, they can't tell specifically 100% what appliance you're using. Although it has come out from a German research group, so they can tell what you're watching on TV through your smart meter. But in the near future, all appliances are going to be called smart appliances. LG, Samsung, all these companies are rolling them out. These are, say, your refrigerator has a built-in computer. It keeps track of everything that's in your fridge. It gives you recipe ideas and stuff like this. But it's also storing all that information and sending it back. So literally, you're going to have government agencies, third-party agencies, knowing what's in your fridge, knowing what you're cooking, knowing everything.
In future, we will live in intelligent houses that control our energy consumption easily, conveniently, and intelligently without us really noticing. Air conditioning, heat pumps, freezers, refrigerators, washing machines, and tumble dryers will all be controlled intelligently. The consumer could simply use an ordinary mobile phone or plug in an adapter to automatically start and stop the appliances, depending on the price of electricity. The price of electricity, in turn, depends on how windy it is.
The current CIA director in the United States has come out and openly admitted, we will spy on you through your dishwasher. Now that's made possible through the smart grid.
Ultimate goal of this smart grid is what it's turning out to be, is really everything is going to be hooked up to the smart grid. You got the smartphones, you got the smart appliances, you got the smart meters, and you know, basically the financial way of things will be also through the smart grid.
Samsung's has brought out their new smart TVs that have built-in microphones and cameras with facial recognition software and voice recognition software. They promote it as so we can better tailor like for your viewing for each person in your home. Well, it's just like Google has used your microphone and your webcam for years now.
It's an invasion of privacy.
Yeah, they've been using your microphone and webcam to get better advertising for you. They listen in, and if you say, for example, you have a dog bark in the background, you'll get an ad for dog food. It's total invasion of your home. It's total 1984.
Yeah.
I think Big Brother of 1984 would have dreamed of having this technology.
So the future, if we allow it to happen, they're going to know our hydro consumption, be able to control it. I'm pretty sure they'll be able to control the appliances within your home through the smart meter.
Oh, they've already said that. To be able, in a time of high power usage, or if there's any strain on the grid, they'll be able to shut off the hydro to your house. There's also what they're calling smart healthcare. There's already been, once again, this has been very slowly implemented. Started off where, you know, for seniors, they have the thing that they wear around their neck, and they press a button if they're in trouble and an ambulance comes.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
Okay, well now this is basically that, but tied into your smart house that goes under the smart grid. So you'll be wearing something that takes your heart rate, your all your diagnostics.
Oh my God! You know,
it sends that through the smart grid to your doctor's office.
Oh wow! Do you guys have any idea what the implications of that is? This is insane. Wow. So picture this: everything's hooked up to the smart grid. All of a sudden, they're gonna know how your heart is, what type of health you're in,
what you're eating, everything.
Wow. Be hooked up to the smart grid, everything.
That's all stored in a database. So not only will they know it for like what it is right now, they'll be able to look back a year ago.
Exactly.
Oh, this person was eating this, their heart rate was up this much, now they've gotten healthier, they're eating this. They'll be able to tell the whole progression of whatever you want.
Wow.
The big story out recently is the IntelliStreet light post. With cameras and microphones built in, they're going to be putting them into American cities, as well as audio recording devices into transit systems. So basically, from what we've already shown you, is that smart televisions, the smart grid itself is going to be able to tell, watch, and listen to everything you do in your home. Now they're just taking this out onto the street to a whole new level, like the CCTV camera systems are going to be put into the smart grid through the light posts, as well as transit, so we can pretty much track and watch everything you do, and guarantee that all that information is going into, say, like a fusion center or something like that and being stored.
On like CCTV cameras, which are just like placed here and there, these new lights, every single light post will be camera, right? And plus it has audio too, because you can communicate with it. I saw a button that you can push and communicate with.
Inventor Ron Harwood unveiled the intelligent light in a ribbon-cutting ceremony. With funding help from the Department of Energy, Harwood's Farmington Hills company, Illuminating Concepts, started designing the wireless communication September 11th and Hurricane Katrina. LED video screens and cameras add to the wireless infrastructure that is remotely controlled. It can provide entertainment, save energy, make announcements.
This is a security alert.
And it even counts people for police. When I come into view of that streetlight, when I look at that camera, the person on the other side sees the white specks and the black marks, sensing that somebody's there. And if they want, they can even take my picture. The system is also capable of recording conversations, making critics cry invasion of privacy.
We'll have microphones as well as speakers, digital displays that will display any kind of advertising, any civic announcements. When I think of civic announcements, I think of Department of Homeland Security putting in, if you see something, say something, into say like Walmart's, that will be put onto the streets. Now this is all down the road, don't expect to see this overnight. These are all pilot projects just coming out. But it's all a progression. You see how it's all tying in together into the smart grid. It's total information control.
Yeah, if you look into InQtel, it's a corporation that is a CIA front. They're using high-tech companies to gather information on the public. So they got now you got your camcorder. They got camcorders that are Wi-Fi hooked up to these. You got cell phones, you got the lights, everything's going to be hooked into one thing, total control of information, and that kind of brings us into the new Xbox.
Yeah, the patent filed by Microsoft, GameSpot Games actually ran a story on it, explaining how it's going to access all, say like cell phones or cameras or if you've got a smart TV with a camera in it, it's going to access those cameras and see who is watching the content. And say if there's too many people watching a movie on an Xbox, they're going to force you to charge for extra copyright fees so those other people can watch. It's totally Orwellian.
You know, Xbox has been spying on their customers in the past. Just take a look at the Xbox 360 Kinect camera. In sections 9 and 12 of the terms and conditions basically state Microsoft will use the Kinect to record and obtain personal information including but not limited to voice, camera, and gameplay sessions and share them with any third party they please. So I'm pretty sure this new Xbox will have the same thing in their terms and conditions, so you should definitely check that out if you plan on getting it to see for yourself.
Over time, appliances will feature the new technology when we buy them. In future, we will also use electricity for things that previously required a different power source. The petrol car will be replaced with an electric vehicle. The houses of the future are insulated and energy optimized for extremely low energy consumption. Zero energy or plus energy houses will be built and will be able to intelligently control the charging of the electric car, our heat consumption, and the starting and stopping of the washing machine and other electric appliances. And the whole process will be as easy as using a modern smartphone.
Everything is going to be hooked up to the smart grid. You got the smartphones, you got the smart appliances, you got the smart meters, and the financial way of things will be also through the smart grid.
So what's some theories as to why you think BA International is ending its contract with Bank of Canada?
Moving towards cashless society. It said in the article that it was because of the new polymer bills. They last longer, so they won't need as much money printed anymore. They don't need as much money printed anymore is because they're moving it to smartphones. They're bringing in the technology to just tap and scan your smartphone like you would with a credit card at Tim Hortons or somewhere.
So basically, you know how they're printing our money. If they don't contract the work out, then where's most of the money coming from?
Well, it will be for the time that it's left that we actually have paper currency. It'll be those plastic bills that we have. Well, I guess they last longer. But we know right now, I think the cashless society is coming a lot quicker than anybody anticipates. My guess is 10 to 15 years. 10 to 15 years, and we won't even need it.
I think even sooner than that.
It could be even sooner. That's like, you know, giving it a buffer zone, you know. The new iPhone that's coming out right now has the built-in chip to make payments. Walmart and Apple have teamed together, and they're doing trials of people being able to pay for purchases at Walmart with their iPhone just by scanning the Q code and paying for it on your phone.
Yeah, so that's all part of the whole mint chip idea, eh?
Yep. It's a whole cashless society coming in, and so of course they're not going to need the paper currency anymore. They're not going to need to contract it out.
Ever since the beginning of time, people have been buying and selling and using whatever currency was available. But today's digital economy is changing faster than ever, and currency has to change too. It is. Introducing Mint Chip from the Royal Canadian Mint, the evolution of currency. Money, as we know it, is fine for today, but tomorrow is a different story. Imagine a whole new breed of transactions that are smaller, faster, and virtually everywhere. That's where Mint Chip comes in. Mint Chip is currency in a digital form. Using a chip, you securely load value onto a smartphone, USB device, computer, tablet, or cloud. Maybe even some future device that doesn't even exist yet. Now, you're ready to go.
It's full economic control of everything. There won't be a dime that you make or spend that they won't be able to know about.
Exactly. So every transaction you make, every dollar you make, who you give money to, is all going to be recorded into a database. And look at how banks are treating their, customers now.
if you use your debit card, you're only allowed a certain amount of transactions per month. Now, imagine if that's permanent. They're going to be charging you money to use your money that doesn't technically even exist because you can't see it.
And it's just some numbers on a computer or on a cell phone.
I think people won't really, really wake up till they see it hardcore right in front of them. Till they really start seeing the paper being diminished and the coins being diminished.
Even with that, PayPal Canada did a survey not too long ago where 56% of the people they surveyed want cashless society. They want to be able to pay for things with their smartphones. So, I mean, to a large majority of people, it's going to be easier. It's more convenient.
Yeah.
I don't have to carry around change in my pocket. I don't have to carry around a card. I can just have my smartphone. All right. And it gets even scarier. I just wrote today about Finn Fisher, spyware program. It takes full control of your phone. So if you've got your finances on your phone, governments that are using the spyware can track your purchases. You don't even need to check your bank account or nothing. They can just check your smartphone.
Oh, wow. And that's what people need to realize. That I didn't even realize this till you just told me that the transactions are actually stored. That data is actually stored within the phone.
Yeah. And it's just like, you know, iPhones for years, it's been public knowledge that they can track you on GPS. And it stores your GPS locations.
Why don't you give us a little bit of insight on how the software you were talking about that the government has, the Canadian government has, to be able to spy on us through these iPhones.
Well, it's not only the Canadian government. They've now found it on servers, public servers in 10 different countries that span 5 continents. It's worldwide. And what it is the software that they use in the Arab Spring. Governments use it in the Arab Spring against protesters. It can turn on the microphone on your smartphone. It can turn on the camera. It can turn off the camera. It monitors all the text messaging. It monitors all the phone calls. So it's full information, whatever they want to do with it. But yeah, if we continue it on, like, that's scary stuff. They can control everything in your phone. And then you're putting your finances on the phone. Who's to say, like, you know, that whole theory, if we go cashless society, the government's just going to be able to turn off your card or turn off your chip. They don't even need to put an RFID chip into you. They've already got it in the phone. They can have that spyware put into your phone, and it just shuts it up.
In the smart grid, even our transportation is going to be tracked, traced, and stored. In the United States, all cars manufactured by 2015 will have a black box in them, just like an airplane does, to record every movement. Now, they're also putting the smart grid technology into the public transit system. Here in Southern Ontario, it is the Presto Smart Cards that's embedded with an RFID chip. That once you load money onto it, you just have to tap it onto basically right now any transit system in the GTA, whether it's GO Transit, Hamilton Transit, Burlington Transit, Toronto Transit. It's usable in all those places, so it's very appealing to a lot of public transit users who commute back and forth on a daily basis. But the reality is that's tying into the smart grid and tracking every time they travel. Every time they jump on a GO train to go to Toronto from Hamilton here, it's being tracked, traced, and stored. So it's total information control.
January 1st, 2013, Hamilton Street Railway is phasing out their paper tickets and paper monthly passes, which will make them no longer available. Here is a quote from HSR. As the HSR is working to eliminate paper fare media and move all our passengers to Presto Card, we will not be issuing senior paper tickets or senior monthly passes, but be offering this discount when they use a Presto Card. This means, you know, there's no paper or coin currency available. Everything is electronic, like debit, chips, and the government and banks have full control of the money supply. This Presto card is playing a key role in that to manipulate us to accept a electronic transit system, which will ultimately be part of the smart grid. So right now, they're not forcing any of these ideas onto us. You still have the choice of paying $2.55 change to get on the bus, but you will no longer be able to purchase monthly bus passes without purchasing a Presto card. And if you have the Presto card, you will have the benefit of paying $2 per ride instead of $2.50.
Agenda 21 started at the Earth Summit in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil in 1992. It was a United Nations agreement that 178 countries, including Canada and the United States, signed on to.
Okay. Over time, it's now called sustainable development. How would the smart grid tie into sustainable development?
Okay, well, sustainable development was like at the forefront of Agenda 21. Agenda 21 is a plan to implement sustainable development at a local level. How the smart grid ties into that is all energy consumption. Sustainable development calls for intelligent use of our energy sources. So through the smart grid, the power companies are going to be able to send power to your home. But if you've got a wind turbine or a solar panel, it will be able to pull energy from that to give to others as well.
Okay. Now, you think sustainable development has everything to do with carbon taxes, correct?
Carbon taxes are a big part of it. Cap and trade, et cetera, et cetera.
Now, in case if you are not informed about the truth on climate change, I'd like to quickly inform you that climate change is linked to the sun and has nothing to do with greenhouse gas emissions. There is much evidence to suggest that, especially when all of the planets in the solar system are heating up simultaneously. In fact, one of Jupiter's moons, which is further away from the sun than the Earth, was made up of ice, literally melted into liquid while in orbit. Climate change is real, but the source of the heat is the sun. The CO2 emission is all lies. It's all done to manipulate the population to accept a global, unlawful carbon tax, which will ultimately fund the United Nations takeover to establish a one-world government, which is Agenda 21, a bunch of goals global elites want to accomplish by the end of the 21st century. I speculate they will start building these windmill and solar generator farms all over the world and combine it with technology we use today so that carbon tax can exist. Because one is clean energy and one is dirty. Realistically, solar panels and windmills cannot produce enough electricity to power our industrial complex. I theorize they are manipulating us to use their renewable energy that we have to pay for instead of us actually using and installing that technology for ourselves on our own properties. They want to make sure we don't become free from electricity bills. Windmills and solar panels do produce enough energy to power our homes without having to use hydroelectricity, so off the grid. Pattern Energy Group and Samsung C&T Corporation are both building these types of things all over the world right now. Samsung is building the biggest windmill farm in the world just outside of Hamilton, Ontario in Haldimand County that is over 500 acres large.
Well, would you agree that the reason why these wind turbines and solar farms are being put up is to kind of have it gives a reason to have carbon taxes, because the smart grid is actually combining energy from renewable energy and non-renewable energy, and by having that non-renewable energy existent, it kind of gives leeway to manipulate people to pay carbon taxes, because the non-renewable way of making energy is obviously they're stating carbon.
Absolutely, the old ways of creating energy that create carbon dioxide are still the most cheapest form of energy that we have. When you get into solar and wind and everything like that, the new technologies, it's very expensive, so most people are still using the old technologies. They begin to tax those people, it's going to force them into the less efficient energy sources. It's going to gain a lot of money for the people who are behind it, like Al Gore. It's forcing a shift in the way that we receive energy. Well, let's look at this. Things like wind power have been around a lot longer than the last 10, 20 years. And they're just being brought out on a large scale now, because it took whoever you want to call them, the elites, the bankers, the globalists, whatever you want to call it, quite a while to figure out a scheme so that they still are in control. Now, if everybody had a wind wind turbine and solar panels on their own home. They were generating their own power off of the grid. That's taking control back for yourself out of their hands. So they needed to devise that way that they could still be in control of it. So now they're generating all of this energy still, just like they are now, and still charging everybody for it, and still in control of the whole operation, even more so under the smart grid. And they're still, yeah, in complete control rather than us empowering ourselves.
So would you be able to give us a rundown exactly what is Agenda 21? Like, what are the main things they want to accomplish?
Well, the main pillars, there's about 40 different chapters in it. To break it down, what they want to do is control every aspect of all of our lives.
Could you name some aspects? Like, I know energy is one.
Property, land rights. They want to remove the ability to own private property for the collective good. They want to have mega cities with the rest of the areas around the mega cities off limits. That's the eventual goal. And with the smart grid, it's total information control. They're going to be able to know what you buy, what you throw into the garbage, what you cook, how carbon friendly you are. And we see that already being implemented in the passive homes that are hitting Europe. These are homes that track your carbon usage every day. Yeah, they're already bringing out the carbon credit schemes. In the Super Bowl, they were really advertising this. You could offset your carbon footprint for your travel to the game or anything like that by buying a carbon credit. Now, what is a carbon credit doing to get rid of that carbon dioxide? Absolutely nothing. It does nothing but take your hard-earned money and put it into the pockets of the globalists. Well, think of it this way. Think of centralized power. When you have a group of any people who are in control of everything and they know all information about you, smart appliances, the smart meters, the smart grid, tracks everything you do in your home. You walk outside, the IntelliStreets program, the CCTV cameras, they're going to know every move you make. So say if you throw a recyclable item into the regular garbage, they'll have knowledge of that and they'll find you. It's forcibly shifting humanity into the direction that they want while they're still in control. Agenda 21, it looks pretty on the outside. It looks nice. It looks great. Who doesn't want to protect our environment? But just like anything else, the truth is in the details. When you see the real agenda behind Agenda 21, it's nothing more than total information control, total land control, total food control, total water control, total control over everything. And stay tuned for the film that we're working on right now, the United Nations Rise of Agenda 21. It's going to give you everything you ever wanted to know about Agenda 21 and sustainable development, from the history, where it began, where it is right now, and where it will take us in the future.
So we clearly see that this is an Aurelian state being established. People need to be asking questions like, why are these technologies being implemented? Are they specifically for our safety, or are there other interests at hand here? We need to come to the realization that there is elite families that are intergenerational planners that perpetuate their agendas through their families. They are bred to basically perpetuate this agenda.
Incrementally.
Yes.
With stealth.
So we can look right back at the Orwell's 1984 and clearly see that in 2012, it's pretty much 1984, we can see that Microsoft is being very greedy in this sense. As we can tell, they're saying we need these cameras so we can tell if too many people are playing the video games, and we charge them, you know, as
the copyright.
Yeah, because the copyright, which is pretty ridiculous. Like, you used to go to Blockbuster or something like that, rent a video game, you and your friends can play it. But now it's like, oh, that's only for you. And since that something else is going wrong, you're sharing it with someone else, God forbid, you will be penalized.
Yeah.
Like, it's ridiculous. Don't support their products. That's the best way to basically kill these snakes, is not supporting them. We are the force that feeds them, so to say. So therefore, we need to take our force back and implement it into more important areas.
Couldn't have said it better myself, absolutely. And even with the CCTV cameras on our streets and these light posts, all this is up to us. We hold that power. We can pressure our city councils into rejecting it. But if we sit silent, they're just going to push it through. So it's up to every one of us. Boycott these corporations. Become active in your community. Become active in your community politics.
Yeah.
And we can stop it right
just,
there.
Just like how Lawrence puts it, you know, you need to become politically active to make political change.